See, one, some things that we face with infants, one of the most common things is GERD.
Yes.
No? So, GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease. That is why ipecac becomes a very important remedy. So, it is the anti-emetic.
Mm-hmm.
But the anti-emetics in the conventional science are very dangerous. Some of them, like largactyl, are even used for depression and to cut down seizures. So they have a very dangerous impact on the brain, whereas the ipecac works as in a very good way. So nausea, retching and reflux is a very common thing with infants. Sometimes, you know, they are introduced too prematurely to solids and then they start to retch and vomit. So ipecac plays a beautiful role in just calming that down.
So this would be, I'm just trying to think how you use that as an interferon with
a constitutional?
Yes.
So, no, supposing it was a case of Heckler Lava child.
Mm.
Now, Heckler Lava is a great remedy for GERD as well. As long as Heckler Lava is covering the picture, I would not even think of ipecac even in a situation of vomiting. If I'm finding intolerance to heat, redness, a lot of anger, painful dentition, which is one of the domains of Heckler Lava, I would stay with Heckler Lava. But sometimes that Heckler Lava does not act and you get very typical symptoms of ipecac, especially nausea and vomiting with absence of thirst and a heightened irritability, almost chamomilla sina like state. That is when ipecac can be considered as an intercut. It plays its role, it pacifies the things, and then soon over a period of time, the child comes back to his indicated constitution. The antimonium group is to do with the vaccine.